A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 16th June, Sunday, on the front page you have Dr. Stir, Home Ministry sends advisory to West Bengal. So now the strike in West Bengal has entered the sixth day and Mamata Banerjee says that all demands have been accepted. Even the central government, you can see, has sent advisory to the state government. This is want to make India $5 trillion economy by 2024, says PM. So at Niti Aayog meet, he set up the Agri Task Force and asked states to boost growth. So Agriculture Task Force has been established. It was Niti Aayog's fifth governing council meet. So in the governing council meet, all the chief ministers of all states and lieutenant governors of union territories participate with Prime Minister heading it. And see, said that each state must aim to at least double its economy if the country is to achieve the target of $5 trillion economy by 2024. Then below you have Hong Kong suspends extradition bill. So this is in Hong Kong. There have been protests against the extradition bill which allowed extraditions to mainland China. So, people had been protesting on the streets and now the Hong Kong leader, Carrie Lam, has said that the extradition bill has been suspended. Then below you have, Bhutan throws up paywall amid surge of Indian tourists. So, flood of unregulated tourists has prompted measures from the pristine Himalayan country. So, for centuries you can see, we have seen that India-Bhutan relations have been with open borders. There is no need for any visa to visit Bhutan. So now, but then the surge of tourists have become an issue. So that is why entrance fee has been imposed by Bhutan. On page 5 you have, as smoke billows from city fields, government misses the fire. So now farmers forced to burn stubble in absence of help from authorities has become a burning issue, a stubble burning issue to be specific. So stubble burning produces particulate matter which can lead to various ailments like heart attacks, worsen bronchial asthma and also other respiratory diseases. So pollution due to stubble burning in adjoining regions results in Delhi suffering. So that is. On page 9 you have, Eastern Himalayas, a treasure trove of balsams, yields 20 new species. So, Eastern Himalayas means in the northeastern region. So, here these balsams have been found, new species have been found. So, these plants are highly sensitive to climatic conditions such as extreme drought and extended exposure to sunlight. And they have been found in Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim. Then below you have, Maharashtra stares at severe water crisis. So 8 of the 9 major dams in Marathwada region have gone dry, and CM Fadnavis as such, Devendra Fadnavis, has promised action. On page 10 you have, Islamic State unit in Kashmir linked to Pakistan. So National Investigation Agency has filed a charge sheet against 4 Islamic State Jammu and Kashmir activists and they speak of handlers from Pakistan. And below you have, opposition finds itself in disarray. So with the 17th Lok Sabha set to convene on 17th June 2019, so non-NDA parties are yet to meet, they are in a disarray. So they have yet to even talk to one another on floor coordination, and they should hold meetings on the approach for the session too, the monsoon session which would commence now. On international page you have, China backs move to suspend bill. So this is regarding the extradition bill in Hong Kong. It has been suspended now and Chinese government has also supported this decision of Hong Kong leader. And then you have here, targeting tankers in the Gulf. So we had heard of the Gulf of Oman incident in which 2 oil tankers were attacked. So weaponizing the Hormuz Strait is one of the suggestions given. But then this can turn out to be dangerous. So there is this Strait of Hormuz as such, connecting the Gulf and the Gulf of Oman. Here you can see the vessels which have been attacked, detailed out. US has accused Iran for the attacks. It is US-Iran tensions which is seen in this region now, the Gulf region. Then below you have US allows Iraq to import Iranian oil. So 3-month extension to waiver has been given to Iraq. Iraq can import Iranian gas for its power grids for another 3 months. Iraq and Iran are neighbors too. On business page you have no trade action against India as of now, US trade representative. So it has said that no announcement of a trade action against India at the moment has been there, but then there are concerns which USA has on the huge deficit or huge trade imbalance which is there. India has a trade surplus with USA, and also we saw how the tariffs have been imposed by India on 29 US products now in retaliation to the tariffs on steel and aluminium from India in USA. And below you have ACHEC labor laws must be scrapped, says staffing body. So most of the regulations which are there in the labor laws have been written for a different era and they are irrelevant to present times. So this is what the Indian Staffing Federation, a staffing industry apex body, says. So it is said that these ACHEC labor laws should be scrapped. Here you can see, like, the enterprises prefer to remain tiny, below 20 people, in order to stay away from the burden of unrealistic labor compliance demands. Then on page 14 on Sundays, you have here a FAQ coverage, frequently asked questions. So those issues which have prominently been in news are covered up here. So here you can see, one is, in cricket, how does DLS method work? So this is Duckworth-Lewis turn method. So this is the history being spoken of, when and why this method was introduced in cricket to handle rain interruptions in one day matches, and what will be its impact on the ongoing ICC Cricket World Cup. And this is regarding protests in Hong Kong against the extradition bill. So it asks question, it answers questions. Why has a draft extradition bill sparked huge demonstrations, and are relations with China deteriorating? Relations between Hong Kong and China. And the third article covered is, why does Assam need more foreigners tribunals? So, because the NRC drive is reaching its final stage, the central government has sanctioned more tribunals in Assam. And this article talks of how will they work too. Then on Sundays, you have science and technology coverage. So here you have the first news. Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research finds key protein conferring radiation sensitivity in cancer cells. So there is a protein which can confer radiation sensitivity. So the immediate medical benefit of this finding is that it can be used in the treatment of certain cancer patients. So this, if cancer cells can be specifically picked out and given radiation sensitivity, they can be specifically targeted. And this is an ode to Mendeleev and his periodic table elements. So the periodic table of elements symbolizes the logical cogeny, principled rationality of all science. So you should know about the history of periodic table. It is done at school level, that how first it was elements were arranged based on atomic weight, and then it was understood that it is atomic number based on which the periodic table has been, the classification of elements has taken place. So it was Mendeleev's periodic table, and now we also have the modern periodic table with us. Then below you have clues from crickets. Can temperature influence our body clock? So circadian machinery, the body clock as such, which is also is in scientific terms called circadian rhythm. So this of crickets shows both drosophila and mammal-like traits. So this is a study done on cricket, the tiny insect. And this is NIT Rourkela, converting fruit waste to ethanol. So marine bacteria isolated from Digha and Shankarpur waters have been used by NIT, National Institute of Technology, Rourkela, for converting fruit waste to ethanol, which can be used as a fuel. And this is novel selenium graphene catalyst for fuel cells. So this catalyst provides a cheap and effective alternative to platinum, which is often used in fuel cells. Then there is no news on the last page. So these are the important headlines from the Sunday paper. Thank you.